Spaceship Earth is an Epcot classic that takes guests on a journey through the history of communication. It is one of the many attractions that makes use of the popular omnimover ride system, and we know that it travels at a rate of around 1.2 miles per hour, or 1.9 kilometers per hour. But what I want to know is, how fast through time does it travel? That's right, how fast through time do you travel on Spaceship Earth? The ride takes us from the era of prehistoric hunting all the way to the birth of personal computing and then back to the present, all in a span of about 15 minutes. I rode the attraction a few times and put together a spreadsheet to find the answer. It of course varies wildly from scene to scene, but the average speed worked out to 186.5 years per second. Now, before I dive into the specifics of that speed and the very, very wide range that makes up that average, I want to preface this video with how I put all these numbers together. In general, I measured the breaks in scenes when Dame Judi Dench starts talking about that scene. So when she starts talking about ancient Egypt, that's when the progression towards the Phoenicians begins. And then when we get there, the progression towards ancient Greece begins, and so on and so forth. Since the speed of the ride can change depending on slowdowns for guests who need help getting on and off the attraction, I rode it a few different times and averaged out the durations. Lastly, to get the dates used to measure this time travel, I turned to one of my favorite unofficial Disney World books, A Historical Tour of Walt Disney World, Volume 2 by Andrew Kiste. For full disclosure, I'm not being paid to promote this book. This isn't a sponsorship. I'm just a fan of Andrew's work, and it was the first place I thought to turn to for the dates. His book takes a historical look at Disney attractions, and for Spaceship Earth, he went through every scene and used context clues within the scenes to make as accurate of an estimation as possible as to when they took place. In instances where he estimated a range of years, I ran the numbers from the center point of that range. So all that said, let's dive in. We start Spaceship Earth in the present, 2019, and over the course of 132.5 seconds, we travel back to the Paleolithic era, more specifically, to around 59,000 BCE. To get to that date, I actually had to work backwards. The following scene is the introduction of cave paintings. The earliest known cave paintings are said to have happened between 40 and 52,000 years ago. Dame Judi Dench says in the script that it occurred 15,000 years after the initial hunting scene. So if we split the difference to 46,000 years ago and then add 15,000 years, you end up with 61,000 years ago, or just about 59,000 BCE. Going that far back in just a little over 2 minutes puts our initial speed at 460 years per second. From there, it only takes 24 seconds to reach the cave painting scene. That bumps our speed through time to 625 years per second. But that's nothing, because 18 seconds later we arrive in ancient Egypt to the creation of papyrus, which Kiste pins at around 3000 BCE. That 41,000 year change in just 18 seconds comes out to a speed through time of 2279 years per second. This is where we see the first major slowdown, however, as our development of communication speeds up. The 43 seconds it takes to reach the famous Phoenician scene, estimated to take place at around 925 BCE, drops our speed down to 48 years per second. From the Phoenicians to Greece, it drops again down to 22 years per second, and from Greece to Rome, 10.4 years per second. Heading to the burning of the Library of Alexandria bumps it back up to 23 years per second. This was particularly interesting. As Kiste notes in his book, the library had actually burned more than once, and he uses the previous scene and the script to estimate that it was the burning in the year 640 that we're seeing on the ride. As we move on to the Middle East and their translated backup copies, we move forward to 1382, which ups our speed again to 51 years per second. Now, this might seem like cheating, but Dench uses the word meanwhile to transition to the monk scene, implying that time itself isn't actually passing much. So I guess we drop to 0 years per second? It would mostly line up with when monks were hand copying texts and, you know, sleeping on the job. We then move on to the printing press in 1439, which slows us down to 3.8 years per second. Then to the Renaissance. The Renaissance spanned hundreds of years, but the last bit we see is Michelangelo working on the Sistine Chapel, which occurred between 1508 and 1512. This puts our time travel speed at 4.9 years per second. That jumps up to 9.6 years per second as we head forward to the end of the Civil War over the course of 37 seconds. One of the shortest progressions is then to the completion of the Transcontinental Railroad, which happened just 4 years later. That puts our speed at 0.15 years per second. From there, things really start to compress. 4.6 years per second to the phones of the 1920s, 0.9 years per second to Jesse Owens at the Olympics, 3.4 years per second to the moon landing, and then 0.18 years per second to that generic 1970s computer scene. I'll be completely honest, for that scene, I had to just split the difference between the scene before it and the scene after it. Finally, we drop down to 0.16 years per second to get to home computing. From the home computing that is definitely not an Apple because it would involve using a brand name scene, we then head into the Matrix. So, 1999? Or, the future? I'm not sure. Disney, you kinda lost me with this one. So instead, I just assumed that from the not Apple scene, we start our return to the present. The 338.5-second trip takes us from 1976 back to 2019. That long journey, paired with the short distance in time, gives us our slowest speed yet at just 0.13 years per second. What's also interesting is that time obviously continues, so if I ran these numbers again next year, that initial and final trip would be extended by 0.007 years per second. And of course, all of these speeds averaged out, 186.5 years per second. So there you have it. Admittedly, it's a strange way to look at Spaceship Earth, but it's one I've been thinking about for some time. And while I think it's obviously not as apparent as the scenes themselves, I found the changes in speed to be an interesting way to look at just how quickly we started to progress as a society. For a slow ride, Spaceship Earth moves pretty fast.